I am Ra. I greet you, my friends, in the love and in the light of the one infinite creator. We communicate now. Question 84.1. Questioner, could you first please give me the condition of the instrument? Answer, I am Ra. The physical complex energy level of the instrument is in sizable deficit. The vital energies are well. Question 84.2. Questioner, in the last session you mentioned the least distorted complex protein for the instrument since its body complex was capable of greatly increased distortion. Would you define the protein of which you spoke and in which direction is the increased distortion, towards health or ill health? Answer, I am Ra. We were, in the cautionary statement about complex protein, referring to the distortions of the animal protein which has been slaughtered and preservatives added in order to maintain the acceptability to your peoples of this non-living, physical material. It is well to attempt to find those items which are fresh and of the best quality possible in order to avoid increasing this particular entity's distortions which may be loosely termed allergic. We were speaking of the distortion towards disease which is potential at this space-time. Question 84.3. Questioner, what disease in particular were you speaking of and what would be its cause? Answer, I am Ra. One disease, as you call this distortion, is that of the arthritis and the lupus erythematosus. The cause of this complex of distortions is, at base, pre-incarnative. We refrain from determining the other distortion potential at this space-time due to our desire to maintain the free will of this group. Affirmations may yet cause this difficulty to resolve itself. Therefore, we simply encourage the general care with the diet with the instructions about allergy, as you call this quite complex distortion of the mind and body complexes. Question 84.4. Questioner, the instrument asked the following question. Ra has implied that the instrument is on the path of martyrdom, but since we all die, are we not all martyred to something, and when, if ever, does martyrdom partake of wisdom? Answer, I am Ra. This is a thoughtful query. Let us use as exemplar the one known as Jehoshua. This entity incarnated with the plan of martyrdom. There is no wisdom in this plan but rather understanding and compassion extended to its fullest perfection. The one known as Jehoshua would have been less than fully understanding of its course had it chosen to follow its will at any space-time during its teachings. Several times, as you call this measure, this entity had the possibility of moving towards the martyr's place which was, for that martyr, Jerusalem. Yet in meditation this entity stated, time and again, it is not yet the hour. The entity could also have, when the hour came, walked another path. Its incarnation would then have been prolonged but the path for which it incarnated somewhat confused. Thusly, one may observe the greatest amount of understanding, of which this entity was indeed capable, taking place as the entity in meditation felt and knew that the hour had come for that to be fulfilled which was its incarnation. It is indeed so that all mind, body, spirit complexes shall die to the third density illusion, that is, that each yellow ray physical complex body shall cease to be viable. It is a misnomer to, for this reason alone, call each mind, body, spirit complex a martyr, for this term is reserved for those who lay down their lives for the service they may provide to others. We may encourage meditation upon the functions of the will. Question 84.5. Questioner, could you make any suggestions about the instrument's feet or how they got in the bad shape that they are in, and if alternating the shoes would help? Answer, I am Ra. The distortion referred to above, that is, the complex of juvenile rheumatoid arthritis and lupus erythematosus acts in such a way as to cause various portions of the body complex to become distorted in the way in which the instrument's pedal appendages are now distorted. We may suggest care in resumption of the exercise but determination as well. The alternation of footwear shall prove efficacious. The undergarment for the feet which you call the anklet should be of a softer and finer material than is now being used and should, if possible, conform more to the outline of those appendages upon which it is placed. This should provide a more efficient aid to the cushioning of these appendages. We may further suggest that the same immersion in the waters which is helpful to the general distortion is, in general, helpful to this specific distortion as well. However, the injury which has been sustained in the metatarsal region of the right pedal appendage should be further treated for some period of your space-time by the prudent application of the ice to the arch of the right foot for brief periods, followed always by immersion in the warm water. Question 84.6. Questioner: the instrument asked if the restricted, unpublishable healing information that was given during the first book could be included in book 4 since readers who have gotten that far will be dedicated somewhat. Answer: I am Ra. This publication of material shall, in time, shall we say, be appropriate. There is intervening material. Question 84.7. Questioner: I am sure that we are getting into a problem area with the first distortion here, with a difficulty with a bit of transient material, but I have questions from a couple of people that I would like to ask. The first one especially is of no lasting value. Andrija Paharich asks about the coming physical changes, specifically this summer. Is there anything that we could relate to him about that? Answer: I am Ra. We may confirm the good intention of the source of this entity's puzzles and suggest that it is a grand choice that each may make to, by desire, collect the details of the day or, by desire, seek the keys to unknowing. Question 84.8. Questioner: I can't help but be interested in the fact that this other entity to whom we were previously referring reported being taken on board a craft. Could you tell me something about that? Answer: I am Ra. The nature of contact is such that in order for the deep portion of the trunk of the tree of mind affected to be able to accept the contact, some symbology which may rise to the conscious mind is necessary as a framework for the explanation of the fruits of the contact. In such cases, the entity's own expectations fashion the tale which shall be the most acceptable to that entity, and in the dream state or a trance state in which visions may be produced, this seeming memory is fed into the higher levels of the so-called subconscious and the lower levels of the conscious. From this point the story may surface as any memory and cause the instrument to function without losing balance or sanity. Question 84.9. Questioner: going back to the previous session, you stated that each sexual activity was a transfer before the veil. Would you trace the flow of energy that has transferred and tell me if that was the planned activity or a planned transfer by the designing logos? Answer: I am Ra. The path of energy transfer before the veiling during the sexual intercourse was that of the two entities possessed of green ray capability. The awareness of all is creator as that which opens the green energy center. Thusly there was no possibility of blockage due to the sure knowledge of each by each that each was the creator. The transfers were weak due to the ease with which such transfers could take place between any two polarized entities during sexual intercourse. Question 84.10. Questioner: what I was getting at precisely was, for example, when we close an electrical circuit it is easy to trace the path of current. It goes along the conductor. I am trying to determine whether this transfer is between the green energy centers, the heart chakras. I am trying to trace the physical flow of the energy to try to get an idea of blockages after the veil. I may be off on the wrong track here, but if I am wrong we'll just drop it. Can you tell me something about that? Answer: I am Ra. In such a drawing or schematic representation of the circuitry of two mind-body spirits or mind-body spirit complexes in sexual or other energy transfer, the circuit opens always at the red or base center and moves as possible through the intervening energy centers. If baffled it will stop at orange. If not, it shall proceed to yellow. If still unbaffled it shall proceed to green. It is well to remember in the case of the mind, body, spirit that the chakras or energy centers could well be functioning without crystallization. Question 84.11. Questioner: in other words, they would be functioning but it would be equivalent in an electrical circuitry to having a high resistance, shall we say, and although the circuit would be complete, red through green, the total quantity of energy transferred would be less. Is this correct? Answer: I am Ra. We might most closely associate your query with the concept of voltage. The uncrystallized, lower centers cannot deliver the higher voltage. The crystallized centers may become quite remarkable in the high voltage characteristics of the energy transfer as it reaches green ray, and indeed as green ray is crystallized this also applies to the higher energy centers until such energy transfers become a non-estation asterisk for the creator. asterisk honestation, n. Adornment, grace. Obs. Question 84.12. Questioner, would you please correct me on this statement? I am guessing that what happens is that when a transfer takes place, the energy is that light energy that comes in through the feet of the entity, and the voltage or potential difference is measured between the red energy center and, in the case of the green ray transfer, the green energy center, and then must leap or flow from the green energy center of one entity to the green energy center of the other, and then something happens to it. Could you clarify my thinking on that? Answer, I am Ra. Yes,